determination of moment of inertia. In this lab, we'll learn how to determine the moment of inertia of an object. Moment of inertia, or rotational inertia, is a measure of an object's resistance to changes in its current state of rotational motion. The larger the moment of inertia, the harder it is to change the angular speed or direction of rotation of an object. In simpler terms, if an object is at rest, it is more difficult to get it spinning if it has a large moment of inertia. On the other hand, if an object is spinning, it is harder to stop if it has a large moment of inertia. For a point mass, or a very small object, the moment of inertia is I equals mr squared, where I equals moment of inertia, m equals mass, and r equals distance between axis of rotation and the mass. For large rigid bodies, like this disc or rod, the moment of inertia is obtained by adding together the moment of inertia of all the different parts of the object. In this lab, we'll learn how to determine the moment of inertia of large objects, specifically this disc. If you were told that the mass of the disc is m and its radius is r, what would be its moment of inertia? Do you think it would be just mr squared? Let's find out. In order to find the moment of inertia of the disc, we place it on top of this rotary table, which is connected to this hanging mass by a string. If we let the mass go, the table and the disc start spinning faster and faster. In this case, as the hanging mass falls, its initial gravitational potential energy is converted more and more into the kinetic energy of itself, as well as the rotational kinetic energy of the rotary table and the disc. Finally, just when it's about to hit the ground, it has no potential energy left. All the energy is in the form of kinetic. Applying the law of conservation of energy, we can say that initial potential energy of the hanging mass equals final kinetic energy of the mass plus rotational kinetic energy of the disc and the table. In this case, the first term, mgh, is the initial potential energy of the hanging mass. 1/2 mv squared is the final kinetic energy of the hanging mass just before it hits the ground. And the last term, 1/2 I omega squared, is the final rotational kinetic energy of the disc and the table. In our experiment, hanging mass m equals 110 grams, or 0.11 kilogram. G equals 9.81 meters per second squared. Initial height h is 80 centimeters, or 0.8 meter. We can find out the final speed of the hanging mass from the initial height and time of the fall using v final equals 2h divided by the time of fall, t. The time of fall was 9 seconds. So our v final turns out to be 0.18 meters per second. Final angular speed of disc, omega final, can be obtained using omega final equals v final over r, where r is the radius of the spindle in the rotary table around which the string is wrapped. That radius r is 2.4 centimeters or 0.024 meter. So omega final is 7.5 radians per second. Using these numbers and using our conservation of energy equation, we solve for the moment of inertia and we get I equals 0.031 kilogram meter squared. But remember, this is the moment of inertia of the disc and the rotary table together, since both were turning. So, how do you get the moment of inertia of the disc alone? We just have to repeat the experiment with an empty rotary table, without the disc on top. That way, we will find the moment of inertia of the table alone. Using the exact same procedure, moment of inertia of the table alone turns out to be 0.002 kilogram meter squared. Since the moment of inertia of the disc and the table together is 0.031 kilogram meter squared, and that of the table alone is 0.002 kilogram meter squared, the moment of inertia of the disc is just the difference between the two, 0.029 kilogram meter squared. And that is our result. We saw how to determine the moment of inertia of a large object, a disc in this instance. The most important aspect of this method is that we can determine the moment of inertia of an irregularly shaped object like this rock, which is very hard to determine theoretically. But there is a drawback for this technique, friction. There will always be some friction opposing the rotation of the rotary table, although there are ways to minimize the effect of that. In this lab, we discuss the concept of moment of inertia and learn how to experimentally determine its value for large objects. Now your task is to answer the following questions. 1. Given the mass of the disk was 4.2 kilograms and its radius was 12.8 centimeters, calculate mr squared. 2. Does your answer match with our experimentally determined value of the moment of inertia for the disk? Explain why they shouldn't. In other words, why the moment of inertia of the disk should not be mr squared. Make sure you read the instructions on how to report your answers to the instructor.